Welcome back. Let's look at proposition 4.1. I'm going to assume that I have an inner product space. So I have a map like this with these four axioms true. All right, first thing I want to prove is that if I have a k on the V, I can take it out as well. All right, so part of the axiom, axiom 3, told us that if there's a k on the u, I could take it out. I want to prove that I can take it out of the v as well. That's not going to be hard. And then last one, second property I want to prove is that if I take a dot product with the zero element, I get zero. All right, so let's prove the first one. This is one of those cases where you have to go by the axioms, so you go slowly. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use axiom one, the one about commutativity, and I'm going to switch the two vectors, the two elements in my dot product. Now that the k is on the first, now that the k is on the first, I can pull it out. So that's axiom three. So I'm going to get k vu, and I want to get to k uv, so I'm going to use axiom 1 again. All right, so we don't need to prove it for both components because axiom 1 allows us to switch the order of the components. So if we have it for one, we have it for the second one as well. All right, so the second property you'll prove on a worksheet or an assignment. All right, now that we have our generalized dot product, now that we have our inner product on the vector space, we could start talking about long lengths, distances. We'll talk about angles soon as well. So let V be a vector space with an inner product. Let VW be in V, the length or the norm of V. We call it the magnitude as well sometimes. So I'm going to take, sorry, not a vector. The dot product of v with v, that's going to give me a positive number, and then I'm going to take a square root. Right? So this is part of the reason that we insisted on the dot product of v with v being positive. And then the distance between v and w, that's just the length of v minus w, and so it's the square root of the dot product. All right, notice that the length of an element and the distance between two elements depend on the choice of inner product. It is not intrinsic to the vector space. So, to make that point clear, I'm going to look at R2. We have this new, again, no arrows here, we have this new dot product. All right, so I want to compute a length of a vector using this dot product, and I'm going to compare it to the length using the regular dot product. So find the length of 3, 8 under this inner product. So I need, so this is v, I need to compute v, v. All right, so that's 1 ninth, 3, 3 plus 1 fourth, 8, 8. So that's 1. And then plus 16, that's 17. And so the length of v is root of vv, that's root of 17. All right, so that's the length of v using a weird, funky inner product. Now, using the dot product, let's do it in a different color. I'm going to get the Euclidean length. In this case, the length of v will be square root of 3 squared plus 8 squared. So that's square root of 9 plus 64. That's square root of 73. All right, so you can see it really depends on which inner product you use. All right, let's try another computation. Find the distance between v and w. All right, so I need to compute v minus w. Sorry, in this case they are vectors. So v minus w, that's 2 minus 8. I need to compute v minus w dotted with v minus w. So that's 1 ninth of 2 squared plus 1/4 of minus 8 squared. That's 4/9 plus, oh, same as above, so that's still 16. And so I got 148 on 9. And so the distance between V and W is the root of that. Which, if you simplify, you get, I got 2 root of 37 over 3. All right, so really to compute the distance between two elements, we look, so this is V and W. You look at the difference between them, so V minus W, so up. And you look at its length. The length depends on the inner product, so the distance will depend on the inner product too.